What's good, YouTube? It's your boy, Chi No Boy, and I'm back again with another video. And today, we'll be talking about who I believe the New York Yankees should be acquiring in this year's free agency. So please drop a like and subscribe to the channel for more information like this. Comment down below who you believe the New York Yankees should be acquiring in this year's free agency and how it'll be helping them. And what should I use for the next video? Any types of suggestions or anything can lead to something bigger and better. So please like and subscribe to the channel. And today I'll be talking about what I believe the New York Yankees should be getting. If it's rumors, if it's whatever it is through trade, free agency, new management. We're just going to be talking about it all. We're going to get into it. So let's get into it. So first things first, what I believe the New York Yankees should be acquiring and looking into acquiring. I believe they should be looking into acquiring Corey Seager. So the reason why I say Corey Seager is because Corey Seager is just a great left-handed contact hitter. He could defend pretty well, you know what I mean? The Yankees, they have good defense as it is in the outfield, especially with Judge. They also have Gallo, and you can put Stanton in there no matter what. You can put anybody down there. I'm just very upset with what the New York Yankees had did as they released both Odor and they released Clint Frazier. I believe these are some dumb moves because I believe that they should have got something back for them. You know what I mean? Clint Frazier has a good bat. You know what I mean? It's just he's always injured. And that's the only thing that sucks about him, you know. And I just believe the Yankees could have got something back. He's very valuable for the team, and I feel like down you know, like maybe next year he'll be more healthy and he's gonna come back better than ever. And I feel like the Yankees should have got at least a pitcher, a reliever, a closer, or they could have got a hitter, an outfielder, whatever they want, you know what I mean? It's just they needed to get someone. And Odor, they got him last year in mid-season. He was all right for the first half of the season when he was with the New York Yankees. Towards the end, he started to struggle as he hit around 210. But the Yankees, I feel like that was a good pickup at the time. Over time, Rune Odor, he got a little bit worse, you know what I mean? They could have just packaged them both up for somebody good, you know? Like a pitcher, we could have got Luis Castillo, you know what I mean, from the Cincinnati Reds. A good right-handed pitcher with a great arm. I also believe that the Yankees could be getting some other pieces, you know? They could have used him in a deal to get Cedric Mullins, as of right now, the left-handed hitter that's in the Baltimore Orioles, the center fielder who was batting over 300 right now. He could have been in good use for a trade. And yeah, you know, this would have been good for the Yankees because they would have had a good leadoff hitter, depending on how the trade would be. And as a lot of rumors have been stating, the Yankees have been looking into acquiring Matt Olson. They're going to have to give up their top three prospect from the New York Yankees. They're going to have to give him up, one of their shortstops. And I feel like, I just feel like that's a good trade, you know what I mean? Because Matt Olson, he batted 271. Here goes the stats if you want to see it. He batted, 271, first baseman for the New York Yankees. As he could hit, he could mash the balls. He had 39 home runs, over 100 RBIs. This man is just a power hitter. This man is good, man, for the New York Yankees. As you've seen in the past, Rizzo is a great first baseman, which we acquired in the midseason. He was a great pickup for the Yankees, especially defensively. But offensively, he kind of struggled in a way, you know what I mean? He didn't struggle, but he started to decline offensively. But defensively, he's always been that one good player. And yeah, you know, Luke Voit, we got to trade him away. I feel like he's not a piece that the Yankees need anymore on this team as he's always injured. When he's healthy, he's good. But I feel like the Yankees, their time with him has run out. And they should be acquiring someone else instead of him, you know. They should trade for, as I stated multiple times, a pitcher or somebody that will be good for the Yankees. You know, we could possibly get like a catcher, a good defensive catcher, which Gary Sanchez is not, but I wish he could develop into in the future as he bats around 220. Gary Sanchez is a good like catcher at times, you know, but lately he's been struggling more and more as he's grown older and as he's been in the pinstripes. You know, so I feel like we got to see with Gary Sanchez. It's almost about that time. If he continues to struggle, I think the New York Yankees are going to have to trade him away, because it's been multiple years with the same things. Same striking out to low pitches, not hitting 220. And I understand you're a catcher and catchers hit around that average, you know. But he's a power hitter. He can hit home runs, you know what I mean? But we just can't continue to have that inconsistent type person on the team. We could trade him for someone that's good, you know. Like we could just trade him for somebody that's a good catcher at the moment. And in the future, I feel like we could maybe trade for some prospects and a player, get a reliever. You know, I feel like Higashioka is a really good catcher, underrated in my book. Great defensive, no doubt. He can hit home runs, singles. He's more of a contact hitter, in my opinion. Yeah, Higashioka is a great backup, and I feel like the Yankees could just use him as a starting catcher. I really like him. You know, he's a great backup, no doubt about it. And if you want to trade Gary Sanchez, if it's about that time, you know, trade him. You know, I feel like Luke Voit is one that has to get off the team. Aaron Hicks is another. I feel like Chapman is another that is taking up. These are players that have taken up our money. You know, I feel like Gleyber Torres next year is gonna have one of the best years. You could come back to this video. This man's gonna have a great year, and I'm telling you right now, be healthy and everything. And yeah, I feel like this team is just great, you know. And another person that was struggling as we acquired him in the midseason was Joey Gallo. Defensively, of course not. He was a great defensive player. Exactly what the Yankees needed and what they wanted. But in the hitting side, he was not what they wanted. It was what they wanted, you know, like they wanted that, but they knew, I thought the Yankees were gonna get something better in the offensive end, but defensively he was amazing. And I went to a game and I seen it. Mans was great on the defensive end, diving for balls, throwing them balls. You know what I mean? This man is a great defensive player in the outfield. But it's just offensively, if you're batting 200 as a left fielder, and no, like 199. What is that for an outfielder? A power hitter. Man could hit up to 40 home runs in a year. He hit over 30 this last year. But how are you going to go under the 200 average as Gary Sanchez? It's very similar to Gary Sanchez. And Gary Sanchez is a catcher hitting better than a left fielder, which is very disappointing in my books. You know, it's like Gary Sanchez is, I don't know, it's like Gary Sanchez is a better offensive hitter than Gallo. And Gallo's a better defensive player than him. It's just crazy, you know? Like, this year, I feel like this year should have been the Yankees' year. They should be trading for pieces this year. Like, if the Yankees, this is multiple years down the road, they continue to keep on doing this. Back to back to back to back. They trade for people, you know? And we continue to be contenders, but we just don't have the right coaching staff, as I believe, you know, the manager. I feel like Aaron Boone should never get that extension. That's in my book. We could have got like a Carlos Beltran, just someone like that. I understand that people don't want him because of the cheating scandals, but we could have got some other people, another manager that would step it up, you know? And the Yankees need to improve that pitching that they have there, especially, you know? Their relievers are good, but they're closing. I feel like they should move Loaisiga to the closing, you know what I mean? Because they need to move Chapman, because Chapman, you know? And starting pitching, I feel like we gotta get rid of Herman. We gotta get rid of Montgomery. He was good, but he was all right, you know. And we need to get better. Left, we could get Deshaun. I don't know how to say his Mencia, from the same team that Matt Olson is on, you know, and the Oakland A's. There we go. And he's a good left-handed pitcher. You know what I mean? We could get Luis Castillo. Good right-handed, great arm pitcher, could throw a good four-seam fastball. You know, it's crazy. It's just crazy what the New York Yankees have, their talent and what they're doing with it and what they could be doing with it. You know, it just sucks. And the Yankees, I feel like they should go in and acquiring Matt Olson. And one big name that I've been looking at rumors and everything, Starling Marte could possibly be a New York Yankee if they sign him in free agency, as is stated from Kent Rosenthal, John Heyman, and multiple other sources, as the Yankees are one of the teams that need a center fielder and that are looking into getting a center fielder, as along with the Mets, the Red Sox, and other teams, etc., and also the Astros. So, I believe that the New York Yankees should get him as he could bat 300 for them, or 290 to 80, but around 300 for the New York Yankees as a number two, number three hitter, number one, you know, one of those three. And he's just a great defensive center fielder, you know. Good offensive one as well. As he's getting older, he's getting better. And that's just the perfect fit for the Yankees. That's exactly what they need, you know. We could have Aaron Judge in the right field, Starling Marte center field, and Gallo in the left. Or if you want to move Gallo and trade him away for a good piece and put Stanton over there, which we would not really need to do. But I feel like what we could do is have those three. Let me restate that. We could have Aaron Judge, Starling Marte, and we could have Joey Gallo. And we could move Giancarlo Stanton to the DH, which he's great at, which he had a great great year, no doubt. Over 25 home runs. Him and Judge went ham, you know what I mean? They just went crazy, you know, and it's just great. He's getting better. I'm happy that he was more healthier this year than he was past years. I'm just very happy. This is the New York Yankees. Giancarlo Stanton, we've been wanting. We wanted the Marlins, Giancarlo Stanton, and we're seeing flashbacks of that. Seeing, like, his peak, you know. And in the playoffs, in the wild card game, man was hitting, mashing balls, which should have been home runs, you know. And he was just great for the Yankees. I'm just very happy that the New York Yankees got him, and we got him for a little price. It's just the money that we're paying is a lot, but I feel like it's worth it as he's getting older and as he's getting better and more wiser and being more smarter with his hits. So, yes, we could use him. And one possible name that we could possibly get is Matt Chapman, which I doubt will happen. You know, I doubt this will happen, but if they want to move him in for like a Gio Urshela type player, I wouldn't mind doing it, because Matt Chapman's a great defensive and offensive. He's great. He's a balanced player. You know, a top five third baseman in the league, top three, no doubt. You know, I just feel like if the Yankees had this lineup of Aaron Judge, Starling Marte, Joey Gallo, DH, Giancarlo Stanton, starting pitching, Gerrit Cole, first baseman and Matt Olson, second baseman Gleyber Torres, you could move Corey Seager to that shortstop. You could put Gio Urshela at the third base, or Matt Chapman, depending. Gary Sanchez, Higashioka, whoever you want. But this team will be great. And I am telling you, this year, the New York Yankees are going to be better than ever, as they are getting better. As our pitching coach is a great pitching coach, Matt Blake, which I love. Even though the team has struggled at the pitching, the Yankees called up so many pitchers last year, and he made them so great as he developed Jonathan Loaisiga and some other good pieces on the New York Yankees to become better pitchers, you know. And I'm just very happy that we have him in the coaching staff as one of the managers. And yeah, so I just believe that the Yankees, they could possibly get one of those big name free agents, one or two of them, three. You know, I feel like the Yankees, they're spending big this year in the free agency, and they could just get some pitching, some relievers, starting pitching. They could also look into acquiring Robbie Ray, who is a good starting pitcher, who I believe the New York Yankees should get as a good left-handed pitcher, as he had a Cy Young year last year. This man was just great. You know, imagine having Gerrit Cole, you could put Robbie Ray, you could put multiple other pitchers in this rotation, and they'll be amazing. You could put Luis Gil in there. You know, he's developing into a great pitcher. Whatever you want to do, as I stated multiple times in the video, Montgomery, if he's going to stay or not, he could stay. But I just feel like this New York Yankees team this year is going to be one of the best that we have ever seen. It's over. I feel it. As Aaron Judge is going to have an MVP-type season, Giancarlo Stanton's going to match the home runs and RBIs, and Gallo's going to be a Gold Glove winner again. Gerrit Cole, Cy Young winner, possible Cy Young winner. As our infielders, Gio Urshela could possibly be a Gold Glover. It's just crazy, you know? This team is good, and I hope Gary Sanchez can improve his defense as a catcher for the New York Yankees. And yeah, so I just hope that this team could become the team that I am saying right now, and as is rumored. I don't think all these like things I said will happen, but I think Half of the things will happen, you know, and that's what I want to happen for the New York Yankees. And that's just in my opinion, you know, who I believe the New York Yankees will be getting. You know, at least three of those players, two or three of those players I really want and I think they will get and acquire because they're very determined to get them and built this team way better. And yeah, so thank you for watching today's video. I hope you liked the video. Please like and subscribe to the channel, turn on post notifications. Share this with others, family members, friends, everyone, so we can see and we can make it big. We want to make it big out here. We want to continue to be bigger and bigger as each day goes on. Please comment down below which videos you guys believe I should do next. Any suggestions, anything. And please like and subscribe to the channel. Turn on post notifications as we grow as a channel. And I will see you guys in the next video. We out. Peace.